All right, you guys, welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be doing a quick rundown of exactly what changed in today's update. So here we are, we're on the Infinity Ward website, and as far as the general fixes go, the first one is a fix for an issue where explosive rounds on the Rytec AMR could still be equipped in CDL modes, fix for an error players could receive when opening the weapon armory, and fix for an exploit in the shooting range trial. Initially, when I first read this, I was looking for that update that fixes that weapon glitch that would just completely cover your entire screen whenever you pick up a weapon in Warzone and you just could not see anything at all. So we're here on Ashton Williams's Twitter account. She is a senior communications manager for Infinity Ward, and she went ahead and tweeted this. She said, "We've got two patches in the works that'll fix a few bugs. One has weapon tuning, which is the one we got today, and a fix for an exploit, a fix for an error that occurs when opening the armory, and a few other issues. And the second one fixes the graphical corruption issue with weapons, the play again option not working, and more. I don't have an ETA just yet, but we'll share more details when we're all set." So I think we could probably see this update coming in later this week, hopefully before the weekend starts, because that's when usually people want to get on. But if you're curious about those kind of fixes, that will definitely be coming soon. Unfortunately, it is not included in today's update. All right, so now focusing more on the weapon balancing updates for the Foul, we got an increased headshot damage, two hits at range with one headshot, and reduced near damage. For the limbs and lower torso, they're always going to be three-shot kill. All right, so navigating back to Twitter, we're on truegamedata.com's Twitter profile, which is the website that I'm always referring you guys whenever I do weapon comparisons or attachment information. This is their Twitter, so make sure to drop them a follow. So anyways, for the Foul changes, previous damage profile from that 0 to 20 meter range, the headshot damage is going to be 105, chest is 78, stomach is 65, extremities are 65 as well. From that 20 to 45 meter range, head is 72, chest is 54, stomach and extremities are 45, and 45 meters and beyond is going to be 55 to the head, 40 to the chest, 34 to the stomach and extremities. So the last damage drop off is actually 43 meters, not 45. Taking a look at the brand new damage profile, this is what actually changed with the Foul. Foul headshot damage is now 100, 58 to the chest, 49 to the stomach, and 49 to the extremities. So the damage to the head was reduced just slightly from this range. And as far as the rest of the body goes, there was definitely a significant nerf. So now we have to get one shot to the head and three to the body if we're going to try to down our opponent in Warzone. But as far as multiplayer goes, you're not really going to notice that difference too much, because in multiplayer, of course, the time to kill is a lot faster and there's only 100 health. So you can still get a one shot to the head. And I honestly don't think that this is going to affect those players who have a trigger finger as much. If you have a really fast trigger finger, you're not really going to notice this nerf. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the other damage profiles here for the different ranges. From 20 to 45 meters, the headshot was pretty much the only thing that changed here. They dramatically increased that headshot damage from 72 to 92, and from 43 meters and beyond, it is now 69 from 55. So the headshots are really the only thing that they did buff to the Foul from that 20 to 45 and that 45 meter and beyond range. So I feel like even if they did state that they increased that headshot damage, I see it as more of a nerf, because the Foul, like I said, is best used up close and personal. Having this increased headshot damage is going to be pretty much useless unless you can get laser accurate headshots on your opponent. Then I could definitely see where this buff will fit in. But as far as practicality goes, I really don't think it's going to be viable in Warzone. But as far as multiplayer goes, I really don't see this nerf being a difference here, especially if you have a really fast trigger finger and you're engaging in combat in really close range. All right, so next we have the Holger 26. They increased the damage range and they also increased that ADS speed. All right, so for the Holger, it's pretty simple. The ADS went from 383 milliseconds to 354 milliseconds, and the previous drop-off locations were 42 and 64, and the new drop-off locations are now 48 to 71. So with these changes, I personally don't think anyone's really going to touch the Holger that much. You know, that's why it's really important to know the actual numbers when they do weapon balancing updates. 383 to 354 milliseconds, you're barely going to notice this difference here. And these drop-off locations are not even that big of a deal either. So I still would not use the Holger. I feel like no matter how much that they buff the Holger, it's not going to be that viable in either multiplayer or Warzone. All right, so the one that people were waiting for is going to be the Bruin weapon balancing, and all they did was reduce that damage range. So let's take a look at which damage ranges that they actually nerfed it at. So previous drop-off locations were 42 and 65 meters, and the new drop-off locations are 26 and 56. So this close range drop-off here from 42 to 26 meters is actually a pretty significant nerf as far as damage ranges go. I personally feel like it was needed, because that's what made the Bruin so overpowered, is that it was just so flexible from all type of ranges. You could use it and still melt your opponents. And the fact that they reduced this to 26 meters, you're gonna see a lot less less players using this once they realized that it's just not effective as much from this 42 meter range because it was reduced to 26 meters. Now the long range drop off from 65 to 56 meters, you're not really going to notice a difference here because the Bruin is a long range weapon anyway. So when you're using it from long range, you're not really going to notice the damage range drop off. So lastly, we have the M91. They buffed the increased near damage range and the increased ADS speed. So for the M91, the ADS went from 446 milliseconds to 417 milliseconds. All right, so taking a look at the damage ranges, here are the previous damage ranges. Now, if you look at the new damage ranges, these are just very minor changes to the damage ranges. Long story short, honestly, I still would not use the M91. I just don't think that these damage range buffs are significant enough to actually change the meta in the game. People are still going to be using the Bruin over the M91 and the Holger. I really do not see a lot of people using the M91 even after this damage range change. And, you know, if you just take a look at the numbers, man, they speak for themselves. It's just not viable. You know, they barely increase these damage profiles to every single portion of the body here. But yeah, guys, that's about it for today's video. I just wanted to post a very quick update video. Let me know what you think of these updates down below in the comments. Leave a like on this video if you did enjoy, and subscribe if you're new around here. Make sure to join Turbo Nation today. Turn on notifications so you never miss a brand new video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.